so much for stopping back. My name is Amy, and today I'm going to show you how I paint cone flowers using a small scruffy brush and an, which is here, much used scruffy brush, and a number 8 round brush. The picture that I'm going to paint, or similar, is this one. And I'm going to be using Sculpus Yellow, Yellow Light, Burnt Umber, Yellow Citron, and Thicket. These are all Folk Arts products. All of them are Folk Art enamels except for the Burnt Umber, which is the multi-surface brand. And it's good on glass as well as paper, wood, you know, whatever you want to paint with. All right, so what I'm going to do is get started doing the cone part of the flower, the cone shape, which I'm assuming that's where it got its name. I'm going to use the small little scruffy brush to do that. And I'm finding for me, these take a little bit of time to do just to get the shape that I want. And I'm basically just using and just kind of dabbing and trying to get the shape that I want. So these probably take the most time out of the whole painting project. Now you can make them bigger if you want. I also was using a bigger scruffy brush, thinking that that would help, and I was not maintaining the desired shape that I wanted. So the kids are off school, so I don't have my grandbabies today, my little grandbabies. And I have my blue heeler dog down here with me. So I apologize if I have to stop and get her upstairs because she does not want to just rush. She's been being really good today until now when I want to do the video. Now she wants to start doing her craziness. So if you ever watch any of my other videos, you will hear me talk about her periodically. If any of you ever have had a blue heeler, she's actually a blue heeler mix. We're not sure what she's mixed with, but something else crazy because of her personality. Definitely, you know, people look at her and think she's a beagle or something because of the way she's marked, but she's not a beagle. If anything, she's mixed with something else that's a herding dog because she is so crazy. Yep, she's going to get started here. The problem I have with putting her upstairs and locking her out is then she'll get into something while I'm doing this because she gets mad. Definitely would not recommend this breed to anybody that doesn't have a lot of patience. She is no longer a puppy. Well, I shouldn't say that. She's probably still a puppy, but she's over a year old, and she still acts crazy. Some of her traits I don't know are going to ever end. She likes to steal stuff, shred things, loves to steal from the grandbabies that I watch, meaning that if they get a toy out, or if we're sitting at the table playing, she tries to get whatever she can, or she runs off with it. All right, so I did have to remove her. So I'm taking my chances that she's not going to chew something up while I'm down here. Anyways, so as you can see, you know, these just take some time. Just take your time with them. And basically just trying to get, it kind of reminds me of a gumdrop kind of shape, if that makes sense. Alright. And I'm going to do 5 because you know that I really funny about using odd numbers. And as I've mentioned in some of my other videos, I need to get some new Scruffy brushes. That's next on my list. I've been buying all these other new kind of brushes and really need to get those next. Okay, so the base part of my flower petals is the yellow light. And if you want to make yours different colors, that's fine. I'm just using the yellow. And I'm using the palette paper, not anything like the black cardstock or whatever that I typically do with my videos a lot of times. I'm using this. So if you want to paint a background, feel free to do that. So it's not light. I'll trim my paper here. So basically with the round brush, I'm just pushing it down and then pulling up, kind of wiggling it a little bit. I pulled a little bit of brown from inside the middle of the flower, which is fine. Kind of like when you do sunflowers, it's okay to pull in some color from the center of the flower. I'm going to go ahead and add another little twisty here. Then I'll continue on doing the same method as I'm doing or have done with the first one. It's okay. And you can just wiggle them, just give them some life, do some little extra ones as fillers or crossover if you feel like you want it. They're just not supposed to be straight. You know, just kind of petals like you do with a daisy. They're supposed to have some movement to them. Next, and you can come up alongside them, and you'll see what I'm going to do to the center here. The center, I will address a little bit more here in a little bit. It's basically putting it down, pulling it up, reducing the pressure. Pushing it down, pulling it up. I'm going to cross this one over a little bit. I'm going to go over here and do this side. There's no wrong or right way to do this. If you want to start on either side, get the sides done, and then do fillers in between, you can do that. I think it's a fun flower to paint, though. And there are others, don't get me wrong, there are other ways to paint this flower. But for the purpose of this video, I'm just doing it this way. You know, just like if you see a spot that you want to fill in a little bit more, just go back in and do it. And like I said, just keep in mind, I will be doing more with not only the center, but with these actual leaves, we'll have another color added to them. Basically just pushing down and then pulling out, lifting up as I pull out. They look really fun to me, like they would just kind of be waving in the wind. If you are new to my channel, please make sure that you subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. Make sure you hit on the little bell. That will allow you to get notifications whenever I post a new video. If you like my video, make sure you give me a big thumbs up. Share the video to others on your social media. That would be awesome. I would appreciate it. So my focus this year is to grow my channel. I really enjoy doing the videos, and I just want to grow it as I get older. Get something for me to be able to keep up with as I grow old. Alright, so here we go. I am going to next then take the same brush. I'm not even cleaning it out. It still has a little bit of the yellow in it. I am going to go into the next color of yellow, and I'm just going to kind of go over some of the petals, not all of them, just some of them, just to add another color into this mix. And you don't have to do all the petals, you can just do some of them. It's just to give it some more interest. I don't even consider it even like shading or whatnot. I think it's just more to give it some interest, so you're not just using one color. And it's really easy. I'm just lightly, you know, going over them, not even trying to completely cover the yellow light. This is the school bus yellow that I'm using. And I'm just randomly putting it on here. Just very lightly. Makes it stand out more. And obviously if you were using, you know, a base color underneath this painting, that would make it stand out more, and I would definitely recommend that. You could do a blue or a nice red, would be pretty. I just today didn't want to take the time. I just wanted to get something posted again and give you something to keep going. I guess that all, any of you that follow me know my goal this year too is to provide more videos. You know, last year I did some. I did more than I've done in the past. But this year I want to definitely, I'm more focused on it and do it more frequently. So what kind of leaves do you think I want to paint on here with this? Give me a comment down below and let me know what you think. You know, I'm a leaf person. I really do like leaves. So if you have any thoughts on what kind I'm going to do, whether I'm going to do full leaves or just something little, comment below. All right. For the stems and the leaves that I'm going to be painting, I am going to, again, once again, I'm not cleaning out this brush. This is the number 8 round brush. I'm just going to dip my brush into the citron or yellow citron in the thicket, and then start drawing my stems. And I'm just going to do very simple little stems. Like I said, I like to do simple, easy paintings because I want it to be something that is for everyone. If you're an experienced painter and you want to do more, obviously this is just a design idea. Not something you have to stick with. It's just to give you some ideas of what can be done. But you don't actually have to stick solely with this design. Create it, make it your own. Give it your own personality is what I like to say. Because we're not all the same. It's nice to grab inspiration I'd love to hear from you. What do you pull inspiration from when you're painting? You know, is it solely just what you see on videos? Do you look at pictures? Do you look at things around you when you're out in society? You know, is that helpful? If you're like me anymore, I don't get out a whole lot. But I do like to paint, so I have to grab a lot of what I do. Inspiration is from the internet or things I've thought of or books, magazines, that kind of thing. I get out so little that the battery of my car keeps dying. I've been experiencing that polar vortex. If you're lucky enough to not be affected by that, consider yourself very lucky. It's been very cold. Second time my car battery is not working. And of course the way the weather was today, I'm not actually planning to go out anyways unless my husband's driving. So it's all good. All right, and then this is the kind of leaf I'm going to paint. Did you think that on here? If you did, give yourself a big thumbs up. These are just simple little fun leaves. It just kind of go like that. I'm going to crisscross them over. You can go back in. You can kind of smooth them out because I am kind of pulling them from the actual... the actual stem. That one I cut a little short. I want more of a pointier end to it. And you could put some wave in it if you want. And they can be a little wavier like the actual petals of the flower. I just like them to have more of a pointed end. So when I'm stopping with this little stubby thing, it's like, don't want it like that. Although I did kind of end it like that, didn't I? Let's go like that. And then put it over. Like I said, very simple. Very simple idea. Not anything that has to be too complicated, because I'm not going to show you too complicated. I like painting acrylic with acrylics. I'm also kind of interested in watercolors, so you may be seeing some of that down the road. I just need more time to practice those before I do that. All right. Now, I think I'm going to stop with the petals there. I don't really want to keep going with those too much. But I am going to come back in here. And then my paint is kind of weird. My white. I'm going to come back in here, kind of try to pull from the bottom up. You know, you can even do some green up in there if you wanted to add more green. Give it some more interest. But with this particular brush, I'm just going to pull from not only what I just painted on here. So you're getting some of the yellow, and that's fine, that's intentional. I'm definitely trying for that look. That's why I like to come back over this. I did put a little bit of the, what if I put that in my thing? I didn't. Of the white, the wicker white. I think most of my basics when I'm doing flowers, really, you're going to see a lot of the wicker white, and you're going to see a lot of the browns. I'm just kind of dotting in a little bit here. I'm trying to get some of that green on here. This or the yellow. I mean, it's green to me, but I'm just kind of tapping a little bit in there. And if you feel like you've gotten like too much of the other color, you know, just go back in, not a big deal, and kind of go over it with the brown again. But I'm liking how it looks. I didn't really want it to be all one color. Anyhow, you could also go in with a dotting tool, put dots in there if you wanted to. But here it is. I like how it turned out. Like I said, it might be more outstanding if you did a darker background. Again, I'm just using palette paper to do the video with. And I do appreciate you stopping back or stopping by for the first time. If that's the case, please, again, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Give me a big thumbs up. If you like it, make sure you share it and make a comment below on what you think. And until the next video, have a good one.